What is up, YouTube? Welcome back to another video on the channel, and today we are going to be doing Free Agency Part 2. If you guys are new, drop a like and subscribe and roll the intro. What's up, guys? Welcome back to another video on the channel. And today, once again, we are going to be doing NFL Free Agency. If you guys are new to the channel, drop a like, subscribe. It's free and it supports the channel. Now, I am doing this the day I recorded the first one, and any extra info I will try and put in also. But so far, what I have here is Geno Atkins was released by the Cincinnati Bengals. Now, Geno Atkins was a defensive tackle. He was pretty good, I'm not even gonna lie. He made a couple Pro Bowls, I'm pretty sure. I'm not completely sure, but Geno Atkins was a very good player, and it's gonna really affect the Bengals in a lot of ways, and that is their D-line. Now, their D-line isn't the best. It wasn't the best to begin with, but now, by losing Geno Atkins, it's not going to be looking too good. We're just going to put that out right now. It's not going to be looking too good. And Will Fuller went to the Dolphins. That's pretty good for the Dolphins. Now, the Dolphins already had Devontae Parker. Now, if you look at Parker, he's not bad. He's their number one. I think they had someone else behind him. But he's not the best receiver. I'm not going to say that he's amazing, but I'm not going to say that he's like horrible, because he's not. Once again, I don't know if he made any Pro Bowl. I'm guessing maybe one. Devontae Parker comes to mind as Dolphins. That's because I feel like he's been there for a while. He was Jarvis Landry's backup. I'm pretty sure this was a couple years ago. And then Landry got traded to the Browns. I think that was 2 years ago. Anyways, Will Fuller, he is, I wouldn't call him injury prone, but he does get injured quite a bit. He got injured quite a bit on the Houston Texans, but he's playing beyond side DeAndre Hopkins, and in my opinion, that's going to give him a lot of like a boost. Now you're going to play with Devontae Parker. You're going to play with the I'm a dude, I'm a dude, I'm a guy, 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 I'm a dude, I'm a guy. They did, because they were 10-6, and 10-6, that's a good record. It's a winning record, and that's a playoff making record. In fact, in the NFC, that would have made the playoffs easily. Probably beat the Bears, because they were like, what, 8-8? That is not a playoff record in my opinion. Once again, you needed teams, and in my opinion, the AFC dominated the NFC that year. Anyways, this will really put a really downside on the Houston Texans. Now look at their wide receiver core. You have Brandon Cooks, who is, keep in mind, a slot receiver and a bunch of trash. So Deshaun Watson with a bunch of scandals. Once again, they were talking about like the crimes that he committed. I'm not going to say them out loud because I don't want to get demonetized and crap, but supposedly, he might be out for the season. Maybe that's just a rumor that's been going around. If he's out for the season, I mean, he probably won't be out for the whole season, you'd think, right? No, maybe a game or two. I don't even think he'll be out at all. But if he is, that will really throw that's going to throw a lot on the Houston Texans. And already, I think they're in a really bad situation, especially giving up J.J. Watt. And they didn't give up J.J. Watt. He wanted to trade, and I don't blame him. You're playing an organization where they've traded Jadavion Clowney. Sorry, I didn't pronounce that right. But they traded him for absolutely nothing. They traded DeAndre Hopkins for absolutely nothing. And you would think, now that J.J. Watt left, that Deshaun has just lost it. And he really wants to go. And now that Will Fuller's gone, he's going to want to go even more. That's just going to add to his pain of just another a reason why he deserves to go, and I understand him. And I think this was a while ago, but I think it was Brett Favre. He tweeted out that Deshaun is lucky to even be on the football team. Well, I guess that is necessarily true, but you don't say that to Deshaun and then you see what he's been through, because he's been through a lot of tough crap. Anyways, that's the day I'm recording this, so there's going to be a lot more free agency, so I'll get you guys back the next day. Alright guys, so it is a new day, and I have a lot of breaking news. Kyle Van Noy was on the Patriots, it was a couple of years ago, he got traded to the Dolphins, and he's going back to the Patriots. I guess that's good for the Patriots. I just went on ESPN, that's what I saw. And Jameis Winston, the person who we thought was going to be a free agent, was a free agent. The Saints did sign a one-year deal, which, in my opinion, is a smart move, seeing as Taysom Hill is a gadget quarterback. Anyways, they did sign him, but I feel like if he gets injured, which he should, because if you're a gadget quarterback, you're going to run a lot, and you would get injured quite a bit. That's just my input on the situation. And Shaquille Griffin, he was on the Patriots. It was either the dude with no hands, or it was his brother. That name just brings a ring. So he was going to the Jags. And I just thought that was kind of interesting. And, yeah, because Jags, I guess they need cornerbacks. They lost A.J. Boye, which he was a Pro Bowl talent. Then their defense was one of the best in the league. Then just everyone went away, got traded, and the Jags were falling apart. So hopefully that will help. They're going to get Trevor Lawrence, so that's also going to help them. Anyways, I hope you guys did like this video. If you guys do like these free, like, agent videos, because it's free agency, please smash that like button, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.